So when the mast cells secrete histamine, histamine, we know, causes vasodilation and increases capillary permeability. Now, you have to think about this happening. It's widespread when you have an acute allergic response. So this is happening throughout the body. And so because it happens throughout the body and you have this vasodilation of the peripheral blood vessels and increased capillary permeability, what I want you to do next is I want you to think about how will this affect total peripheral resistance? How will this affect MAP? And therefore, how can people die within minutes? All right, then I want you to think about what kind of treatment. If you could get to somebody in time that was having an acute allergic response, what kind of treatment, what would you inject them with that would help alleviate these symptoms and prevent their death? Now, going back to the acute allergic response then, when you vasodilate and have increased capillary permeability, that's going to ultimately cause these symptoms like hay fever and coughing and sneezing and so on. So those are just the immune dysfunctions. All right, then there's autoimmune diseases. So what is an autoimmune disease? And then there are immunodeficiency diseases. So what are immunodeficiency diseases? Are any of these congenital? And then stress in the immune response. So how does stress play a role in the immune response? Think back to hormones. Which hormone can suppress the immune response? So I went ahead and I gave you some suggestions for post-class activities. So these suggestions will help you learn this material a little bit better. So you can expand upon your lecture notes, make a concept map for innate and acquired immunity. So you can build off the concept map I've already given you. You can make a table to compare and contrast all the different types of blood cell types. And to do that, be sure you review the blood lab. And then we have the spleen, okay? So the spleen plays a significant role in the body's immune system. So I've left you some questions here about the spleen and wanting you to think about these. If you have questions about these, let me know and I'll be sure to help you.